WP Fluent Form comes with an input field that you can put in your form to enable users to submit files of different types. Here is how you can add and utilize a file upload input field in your form. Please keep in mind, this is a pro feature. Purchase WP Fluent Form Pro add-on from the link provided in description to use this functionality. Drag and drop the file upload input field button in your form editor from the input field tab. Or you can just click on the button and the file upload input field will be added below the last selected input field in the editor. Or click on the plus icon below the last added input field and select file upload field. Hover on the file upload input field and click on the edit button to customize it. Edit element label according to how you want it to be shown in the form. Adjust element label's position using the label placement option. Define admin field level to identify the input field to the admins if necessary. Determine if the input field is required or not. A personalized error message can be set as well. Limit the file size users can upload using this input field using max file size option. Define the error message to be shown if the uploaded file size exceeds the permitted limit. Limit the number of files allowed to be uploaded using max file count option. Define the error message to be shown if the number of uploaded files exceeds the permitted limit. From the checkbox below Allowed Files option, define the formats of files that will be allowed to be uploaded. Define the error message to be shown if the uploaded file formats do not match the allowed formats requirement. In Advanced options, Container class and Element class can be used to style the element. Define a help message if needed. This help message will be shown as a tooltip. Learn more about help message customization in Form Layout Settings documentation. The input field's name attribute is the HTML equivalent of the same name. Define if there are any conditions to be fulfilled for this input field. Learn more about conditional logics in the link given in description.